Hello friends, hope you all are fine, safe and you are studying well in our video lecture. Now in last lecture we discussed the blood, the structure of blood and blood vessels. Today we shall discuss a new topic, that is human heart. As we discussed that the different substances like oxygen, carbon dioxide, nutritive components and waste materials transported in our body through blood. But the blood flowing in the blood vessels like veins, arteries or blood capillaries. But we need a specific organ to pump the blood in each and every part of the body, and the pump is heart. So today we have to discuss the structure of human heart. So let's start. Our pump, the heart. First of all, we draw the diagram and then we discuss the structure of human heart. So, please be alert and be concentrated how I draw the figure. You have to start with this point. You have to keep the 6 or 7 lines here, gap, and then you start the figure like that. Okay, then like that. Now it is like that, and then I change the color. Okay, now here it is like that. You draw it like that. Is it clear? Now, from here, you have to draw like that. One. And two, then three. Very easy steps to draw. Then from here you have to draw like that. Okay, see. Is that clear? Red, black and blue, these colors are different, which show the different parts. Now here we have to draw like that. Here a valve is present. Okay, like that, and here draw like that, and till here this part we have to make slightly longer than these. Okay? Then again here, like that. Okay? Now, here we have to draw the outer line like that. Okay, so it is the shape of heart. Then here okay, so you have to draw it like that. Then this blue line comes from here, back of this part, and comes here. Here, and again it comes here. Okay, then another part of it like that. Okay, then from here I have to draw it like that. And here another part that we have to draw like that. And this reddish part which comes from this side like that. Okay, and it form a valve here. It looks like that. So we have to draw it like that. Is that clear? Now from here these are the cardiac filaments that you have to draw. These are the cardiac filaments. Okay, so it is the structure of human heart. Now we label it. Here the human heart is a pump which transports the blood in each and every cell of the body. It is made up of four chambers. Now why it is made up of four chambers? So here it is interesting that at a time in human heart, two types of blood, oxygenated and deoxygenated, both enters into heart at same time. So the four chamber separate them both, or we can say that it prevent the mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. So the human heart is made up of four chamber. Now if it is made up of four chamber, so we just take a look like that. These are four chambers, 1, 2, 3, 4. So upper chambers are known as atria. Singular is called atrium. So this is atrium and this is the lower chambers are called ventricles. One is called ventricle. Here in figure of heart, the sides are opposite. So when you level, suppose you are sitting in this situation, so it is your left side and it is your right side, but when you draw the heart, the figure is opposite. That's why it is called right side and it is called left side. So here if we level it, it is called right atrium and it is called right ventricle. Same as it is left atrium and left ventricle. So first we label it. What is it? It is right atrium and it is right ventricle. Same, it is left atrium and it is left ventricle. So left and right atrium and ventricles are there. Now here between right atrium and right ventricle, there is a specific type of wall present. But before it, we say that the wall of atria are thin and the wall of ventricles are thick. So wall of atrium thin, wall of ventricle thick. Here the wall which is present between right atrium and right ventricle is called tricuspid valve. For example, it is the valve, so it is called tricuspid valve. And here one valve is present, that is called bicuspid valve. When you see the valve from top, you can see these valves like that. There are three septa present in the valve like that. Three septa, 1, 2, and 3. So it is called tricuspid valve, and when you see it from top, it like that. So it is called bicuspid valve. Only two flaps, and here three flaps. So when it opens like that, close, open, close. So the valve which is present between right atrium and right ventricle is called tricuspid valve, and the valve between left atrium and left ventricle is called bicuspid valve. Bicuspid valve is also known as mitral valve. It is also known as mitral valve. Okay, now the further, the biggest artery which arises or which comes out is this. That is called aorta, that we had discussed in last lecture. So it is aorta. This is the part which transport the blood toward lungs. So when the artery or vein connected with lung, it is called pulmonary. So this is artery. So that's why it is known as pulmonary artery. And this is called pulmonary vein. So it is pulmonary vein. Then these part which take the blood from upper part of the body, that is called superior vena cava. And the below part is called inferior vena cava. Superior and inferior vena cava. Okay. Now, here we can see this is the septum which separate the two ventricles. So, it is called septum. Then, here specific type of valves are present. These are bicuspid and tricuspid, but these valves are called semilunar valves. So, these are the semilunar valves. It is called semilunar valves. And these are the cardiac filaments. Cardiac muscles filaments. So, it is the labeling of human heart. So, hope you are understand and you are able to draw it. So, draw it twice or thrice and practice it much. Okay. Now, we shall discuss the structure of human heart. So, the structure. First, human heart is situated or located in the thoracic cavity between two lungs and slightly towards left side. So, where is the location or position of heart? So, heart is located in the thoracic cavity between two lungs, slightly towards left side. So, location is between two lungs slightly towards left side. Now you can better understand that when we discuss the respiratory system, we draw the left lung slightly smaller than right lung because and we make a slightly gap and this gap filled by the heart. So, it is slightly toward left side. Second, the size. Size of human heart is as a close fist. It is as much as close fist. So, its size is a close fist. As close fist. Then the shape. The shape of human heart is conical, means it is broader at upper part and it is shorter at lower part. So, the shape is conical. Now, the structure. So, as we know that and as we discuss in this lecture that when the oxygenated and deoxygenated both blood enter at same time in the heart, the human heart is made up of four chambers and these all four chambers are separated by the septa. Four chambers, upper chambers are called atria, singular is atrium, and lower chambers are called ventricle, singular is ventricle. The wall of atria are thin and the wall of ventricles are thick. From this right and left ventricle, also the wall of left ventricle is slightly thicker than the right ventricle. Why? That we will discuss in next lecture. So, the wall of ventricles are thick. Then, there is a tricuspid valve between these right atrium and right ventricle, and bicuspid valve between left atrium and left ventricle. What is the function of these valve, tricuspid and bicuspid? These valve prevent the backward flow of blood from ventricles to atrium. So it do not allow to pass the blood which coming from atrium into ventricle. The backward flow is not possible because this valve prevent the backward flow. So this is the structure of human heart. Human heart is a muscular organ having four chambers. Okay, why it is four chamber heart? Because it prevent the mixing of oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. Oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. Then the upper chambers are known as atria. One singular is atrium. These are two, left and right. Same as the lower chambers are known as ventricles, singular is ventricle, left ventricle, right ventricle. Okay. The wall of atrium and ventricle. So the wall of atrium is thin, while the wall of ventricle is thick. There is a tricuspid valve between right atrium and right ventricle, while bicuspid valve is present between left atrium and left ventricle. Valves prevent the backward flow of blood from ventricles to atrium. And the whole heart is made up of cardiac muscles. Okay, the whole heart is made up of cardiac muscles. So it is only the structure of human heart. Now how the blood transport or how the blood flow in these chambers, that we will discuss in next lecture. So it is only the structure of human heart. Okay, hope you all can understand it. And again I request, try to draw these twice or thrice. Thank you.